Welcome to episode 5 of the Roosey Project Vlogumentary presented by the Running Report. I'm Joshua Potts, and this is my running journey.
Let's go, Potts! Right there. And let's start picking up! Let's start picking up!
So every time something get hard, you quit, you call mama. I dare you to take a little pain.
Bro, I hope you guys been enjoying the series, bro. I hope you guys really have. We put a lot of work into this, and it really is just an honor for you guys to sit down, sit through my season. I hope this is a different little shift of things and like running content that you've been consuming over these past couple months. But I'm really happy that this is finally out. You guys are able to see it, and I hope you guys are enjoying it. But let's just get right into this next episode, bro. I feel like this is a really good episode. Really raw, I would say. Like, yeah, it's pretty raw, but that was all just because like this was my last race going into conference. It was really just about the team aspect, and for me it was putting myself in a position to compete once again. I've been trying to do that all season. I only was able to do it about two out of the six races that we had that year, and for this time it was really to just prove all the training and all the work that I put in for like these past 8 months. For me, for myself, it was really just to prove that like this is all worth it. I wanted to get that one good race, that one great race under my belt, that one race when you sleep at night and you really dream, like when you dream about crossing the line the night before. Like, I wanted that type of race, and I wanted that to happen at conference so bad. And so that was really the preparation for me to going into this race. But then on the team aspect, I feel like the preparation was really just bringing up that momentum to go into the next like two biggest races of our seasons, which is SoCal Finals and then State. And so it was gonna be a good day. There's a lot of great vibes. It's the conference meet, it's fun. Like, we're supposed to go in there and win. Everybody came in acting like we're winners, and that's what we did in these conferences over several years, trying to get the team win, trying to get the individual win as well. And let me tell you, bro, this course was hard. You guys don't get to see like the full thing of it, but this course was tough. But you'll see. Let's just get into the video. Let's take it away. Let's take it away.
A stick is something small, but it would be that same stick. I need you to know this because you've never been through this challenge before. You've never been 24 before. You've never been 61 before. I want you to take your stick and I want you to point it at what you can't get over. I want you to take your stick, keep the verse up because this is right from the Bible, and raise your staff. I know it's small. It always feels small. I know that some of you are visited by the perpetual spirit of a never enough, but it becomes enough when you stretch it. It becomes enough when you use it. It becomes enough. This is the miracle of faith. Why? Because God changes things. Say it. God changes things. That's what he does. God changes.
No, absolutely not.
You suck worse. Like,
whenever I come in here, he'd be like,
"Oh, you woke up." He's been asleep like for 2 hours, bro.
I'll take it.
No, I think I got it.
Bro, this dude's been like Sleeping Beauty like for 2 hours, bro.
Like the Lord said, Kanye, thou shalt eat. It's the fruit of the
outbound income.
But I don't know.
We're gonna come out here. We're gonna take over again, like last year, and the year before, and then the year before that one. Easy one.
And Daniel, how are you gonna do this?
I'm gonna do it in trainers. That's how we're gonna win.
How are you gonna do this? I'm gonna do this in trainers.
Put that in there. Put it in trainers.
All right. So you have Isaac Abdallah here, doing your videography for the day. I'll try my best. This course is not a spectator-friendly course. Basically, I'll show you. They start here, they go all around up a little hill, they go all the way out, and then they go keep going out, and then they're gonna come all the way back in, then they'll do like a big loop here again, and then finish back. So we'll try our bestest.
Try our bestest.
Thanks for watching the Runner Report and or Roosey Project. Click the link below and subscribe. Thank you.
Conference means the same thing as it does defending our home course. It means the same thing as winning State for a third year in a row. Same thing as winning SoCals for I don't know how many years in a row again. It's like we have a target on our back, and you want to defend that title because it's been yours, it's been yours, it's been yours. And if you're the ones to lose it, it's not a good feeling.
I knew that going to conference, we had to once again like go out there and do what we do best.
And so to win that, I don't even remember the number, man. Is it 7, 8, 9, 10, 11? I honestly forget. Like, that's how crazy the number is. And so when you're just used to doing it, you do not want to be the one to mess it up. So you want to keep the tradition going. So.
Vicente, let's start going. Hey, good work, buddy. Good work. Atta boy. Let's go, Daniel. Move. Let's go. Good job, bud. Marco. Marco, let's go. Marco, we need this one. We need this one. We need this one. Let's go. Sid, let's go. Atta boy, Bryce. Come on, David. Let's go, Frederick, attaboy.
Run through, Jojo, run through, let's go.
Hey, good stuff, Potts, good stuff. Let's walk through, keep going, get some water.
Bruh, that course was hard, man. That course, one of the hardest courses I ever did. Not even gonna lie. Definitely got beat up on that day. But I'll talk more about that at the end of that. But pretty much, I just wanted to say, shout out to the squad. Isaiah got the dub after being sick for like a week. So he came back and really just brought a whole lot of momentum, a lot of energy to the squad to go into just bigger, better things on SoCal Finals and on the state. It's a really exciting time to be a Mountie at conference, bruh. Just to see all the work being done, like seeing everything that we've been put into place to finally like see it come together with conference, and now next up SoCal and state. We're getting so close to getting that ring that we've been talking about since the summertime. And it's exciting. It's an exciting time to be a Mountie. Real exciting time to be a Mountie.
I think that the feeling of winning conference was even better because it was like a dogfight course. Like 2 miles of it was uphill. Some of us didn't even fully race it. We tempoed. I don't even know if we had our full squad that day or our full squad being healthy. We had our full squad, but not fully healthy.
It felt good to go out there and win conference. I ended up, our coach told us to take that one easy, tempo it. That was really fun. I had a blast with the guys. We went 1-2 that day. It felt really good. So, I mean, I was excited for everything to happen.
And so still to like go in there and then dominate it was like, what are we gonna do when we're fully healthy, fully working together, fully racing? And so it was just, I think it was just one more confidence booster, honestly, no matter how crappy it felt.
Wait, it's blurry. All right, it's good. Daniel Dalla, how did it feel?
You know, we came out here, we did what we did, and we won.
Who you fueled by? Who's your nutrition guy?
I like to thank Nectar.
Okay, screw Clearwater Bagels.
Oh,
I'd like to thank Saki Sushi, you know, for supporting.
No, wait, wait, take that back.
We'll try. And okay, how does it feel, Daniel Abdallah?
It feels really good. I'd like to thank Clearwater Bagel for filling me up. They give me the nutrition.
Of course.
Aloha Bagel with egg, cheese, and bacon. Thank you.
I have the allergies, bro.
Well, you hear it here first, folks.
Hopefully, this is a good shot and y'all can like hear me and stuff. But, hold up. Wait, let me turn this off. So I'm stuck in traffic right now. I'm about to get off, but I just wanted to, since I'm stuck in traffic, not too much going around, let me just give you like kind of like a raw like reaction just over to like my season. So that was like the final race of my season. I think I probably already said that in the beginning, but yeah, that was always my final race of the season. That was my final race. I didn't end up making it onto the state team basically, and I was basically, from you guys seen from earlier videos, just not running up to the potential that I really wanted to, and really kind of just bombed the last couple races. But I wouldn't say bomb the races. It was just the product of I didn't really improve throughout the season. And I think overall, like, this was definitely my worst race time wise. One of my worst, I want to say it's not my worst race, one of my worst races, but like, it's definitely, it's just disappointing, like going in from the starting this season. Like, literally I started my season like back like in May, sort of, because my track season ended like in May, and then I took like a week off, and then I kept on running, and I was running since then. And so like going into this cross country season, I knew that like it was gonna be tough. I haven't run cross country in a minute, and like I was hurt all year last year. I wasn't doing that much mileage at the beginning of this year. I knew this transition was gonna be hard, and I was gonna have to be running a 6K, but I didn't expect it. I knew it was gonna be hard, but I knew I was gonna be able to be capable to be up for the challenge and to possibly be on the state team. And at the end of the year, that was the goal, like to be on the state team. Even though I'm not a cross country dude, and I know to be on the state team at somewhere like prestigious as Mount Sac, that's like a super like big accomplishment. So obviously, like, I'm gonna shoot like to be on the state team. So if I'm not shooting to be on the state team, there's no reason of doing cross country or even trying in cross country. You feel me? So like, that was definitely my goal, and like to go out and to start the year, I was definitely like on that track, I feel like. But I didn't improve throughout the season as much as I wanted to. Every single race was kind of the same, either at the 3 mile mark or the 2.5 mile mark, or even 2 miles at times. I would just hit a wall and run like a 6 minute mile out of nowhere, and that was even happening in my tempos too, but like I was running interval workouts well. There's just, I think a lot of things that I was doing in practice from the start of the summer and then going into tempo work and then definitely into interval work, I think that's where I definitely was losing some ground. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it. I could go deeper into it. I don't know if y'all want to hear all that. I can get spiritual on y'all. I can teach you a whole sermon real quick, but nah, we ain't gonna do that. So yeah, that's my community college cross country season. Not what I wanted it to be, but I'm happy and I'm healthy, and I'm ready to keep training, because only way to race is to train, and I love racing, so I gotta get out there, and I'm ready to start training physically and training even harder mentally than before for this track season. This is last chance, baby, last chance. Let's go get it. Thank y'all for watching. Make sure you comment, like, subscribe, share with your friends, and yeah, bro, I'm sorry for not uploading like consistently, y'all. I know this is getting long, I'm getting preachy, but if you stay to the end, definitely you my dog. If you watch this far in, come on, comment down below that you're my dog, bro. Comment down If you stayed this far to the end, comment down your favorite runner. I want to hear your favorite runner. If you made this far into the video, comment down your favorite runner, because that will tell me if you a real one. I don't know. I bet nobody's going to comment down their favorite runner, because no one's going to have watched all the way through this. But thanks, y'all. See y'all next time. Deuces.
So every time something get hard, you quit, you call mama. I dare you to take a little pain.
We're not just here to take part. We're here to take over.
Tell him.